And again, without comment, I play the video. Okay. Now see it again. So we had three nodules in the right thyroid lobe. Here, here, and here is the third one. I think that these intranodular echogenic figures are also clearly backwall cystic figures. This is a much more difficult case than the previously presented one because there are only tiny cystic areas. But be aware, lines and granules are synchronously present. Occasionally, a microcalcification can be a bit elongated, but such quite large linear forms does not occur in the event of microcalcification. So if you analyze this larger view, almost all of them are located dorsal to very tiny cystic areas. So we have two clues regarding recognition of backwall figures. The first of the synchronous presence of lines and granules, and second, here was a quite typical example here. Is a very tiny but existing cystic area. It is enough to diagnose this linear form as backwall figure. I show you once more this video for the sake of the third module. For this one, please focus on this. It also has synchronous lines and granules, but these occur mostly within solid parts. Okay, it has cystic areas as well, yes, but this is a quite large solid area. In such areas, the synchronous presence of lines and granules are the signs of connective tissue. Hopefully we will see again this small nodule in the video. Yes, now. So it is not evident whether these are dorsal to cystic areas, but the presentation of backwall figures and the presentation of connective tissue are almost the same. Both are characterized by the synchronous presence of lines and granules. It has no relevance to differentiate the connective tissue from backwall cystic figures, but I mention here that these are very similar figures. So, questions, comments about this case? Everything is clear?
Yes, it's